All right, what's up, guys? We are back at AD Motorsports on another beautiful Friday in Chicago. The sun is out, and we have a lot of progress on the Jeep since last time we saw y'all. So I'm gonna apologize once again. I've been out traveling for work this week, so that's the reason for the lack of videos. But just wanted to let you guys know that we are back on this beautiful fucking Friday, and we got a lot done on the Jeep here. So. As you can see, Adam is in the process of wrapping up the exhaust bits. And Adam, what do you think we could expect today in terms of what you're looking to accomplish?
Up pipe to okay. The turbo, manifolds to the turbo, with the wastegate mounted on it.
Excellent.
Yeah, that'll be the goal for today.
That's still a pretty significant amount of work, I would imagine, two people.
Yeah, something like about 8 hour job.
Yeah. As you can see, like I said, in the last week, Adam's been very busy. Once again, beautiful welds here. Sexy goodness.
We're using a concentrate power of the sun, too.
We'll take it, man. And as you guys can see, too, I don't think you guys saw this. I keep forgetting, but we did have the stuff come back from powder coating. And as you can see, we made the decision to go with the wrinkle block, which, as everyone knows, is pretty popular at this point in the game. But
blends in and cleans up.
Yeah, I think it looks clean, especially with the whole stormtrooper look that we're kind of trying to go for with my Jeep here. But hey, Adam, maybe we could drop it down real quick and show the viewers the top side here. We got the intercooler pipes all wrapped up, and then we also have the blow-off valve mounted on there, the tile 50mm unit, which looks great. And the turbo right now is off at the machine shop, right, Adam?
Yes.
Getting that flange on the exhaust housing?
Yep.
Okay, cool. So as you guys can see, pretty cool. So once again, wrinkle black, everything came out great. There's the old tile valve right there. Cool stuff. But as you guys can see, once again, turbo's off at the machine shop, which was mounted to the brackets that Adam had fabbed up there a couple weeks ago. But all in all, it's looking good, I would say. So, as usual, much more to come with this man right here. Once again, owner of AD Motorsports outside of Chicago, home of the fastest second-generation Jeep Grand Cherokee SRT in the world. So you guys will be seeing that Jeep sooner than later on one of the videos here. But if you haven't checked it out, go check it out. Once again, fastest second-gen SRT Jeep in the world today. So we'll check in with you guys in a bit.
Talk to you soon.
Check in here with Adam. Obviously, he's in the process of mocking and sizing everything up from a fit and finish standpoint. But looking good and looking sexy. Adam, so what exactly are we trying to accomplish other than the fit right now?
Because clearly this isn't cut and I should say a fabricated piece, because it's fabricated by hand. There you go. There's a lot of massaging the metal.
Okay.
So a lot of grinding. I mean, it needs to be as smooth and
in
as
terms of the
even,
surface is where it mates right there,
as
right?
As possible, because if it's... If you got gaps, TIG welding, then it just sucks. I mean, you filling gaps that...
So explain that. So I can see on the back here, I can see already what you're talking about right
there.
Yeah,
we're gonna have to massage it, open it up to the basically size of the piping itself. Because what we're using is a flat tubing into a round tubing. So
okay.
We got these two little humps here.
Yep.
So we need to try to...
Totally makes sense.
You know, make it on the same side.
So it's really just that hump at the top there and the bottom that are tricky for you, then,
exactly,
I would imagine,
yeah.
Right?
So you gotta use a little bit of hammer and
to massage it to get it to
mate
out
perfectly. So it's a smooth transition versus
because otherwise, like you said, the weld will probably break and then it'll leak quickly, right?
Yeah,
okay.
And we don't want to use a lot of filler rod on this, so
cool, that works. All right, check back in. Quick check-in here. The reason Adam is taking the piece of pipe to the faucet, I'm sure some of the non-car people are going to ask.
Your grinder gets hot, as you can tell. It's
see the heat
turning a little color, a little brown, a little bit of purple in there.
Cool. Yeah, so he's preventing burning his own hands, basically. Yeah. So that's what's going on, peeps.
Exactly. Cool it down. So another thing is when you get one pipe that's hot, another one that's cold, and you tech it, this one shrinks, weld cracks, so it needs to be evenly heated.
Makes sense. And as you can see, just like you talked about a few minutes ago. That is perfect. Wow.
It needs to be centered, but...
Yeah, but you can tell it's a huge difference from a couple minutes ago.
It's up top and all around more.
Yeah.
It's going to be smooth transition.
Absolutely.
And
Which is important, people. The reason he keeps talking about smooth transition is it's important for the airflow.
Rough edges, sharp edges, all that is nonsense. That stuff will rob your horsepower.
Yep.
You're not creating, we're creating horsepower, I suppose, by turning the boost up, but whatever obstruction you have will rub horsepower. So if you can get rid of it all.
Yeah. So, mission accomplished. As y'all can see, he's got it all tacked up with the old MIG welder over there, and as we talked about in the last few minutes here, everything fit and finish looks great. So Adam, after you tack it up there, what exactly...
We're going to pull it off and weld it.
You still do have to pull it off.
Yeah,
okay. So you'll pull that hole as one section then?
As
unbolt
all
it up
one
there.
Piece, yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't like to tack it in 15 different spots and weld it because the metal does move. And it will move a little bit. And then what needs to be understood is that, or remembered I should say, is if eighth inch or 20 thousandths over here,
mm-hmm.
it will be a quarter inch on this end.
Okay.
So, but by saying that is that whenever you weld it, the metal gently moves, you know what I mean? This isn't, the tubing it's cheaper, it's not very, it's not, maybe I'm saying this wrong. God only knows. I really don't know what's in the metal itself and reacts difference to heat.
Yeah.
Once it cools down, it changes shapes ever so gently. So
that makes sense.
If you can weld it in sections and then build it all as one piece, so to speak, like so, and then you're just doing one thing at a time and then constantly take it off and on and on and off and on and on, it will fit like a glove versus you tacking it all up, welding, and then you get use a pry bar to jam it on there.
Yeah, totally makes sense.
And then the stuff cracks because it's heat stressed, I believe that's what the word is. So yeah, if you can just kind of, it's meticulous bullshit, but
cool. It
needs to be done like that.
Awesome. Well, we will check back in a bit and much more to come. Quick check-in for everyone. So basically Adam's going to clean up some of the welds here and do a little grinding real quick here.
What I'm grinding off is the tech welds that I...
From the MIG welder,
from
right?
From the MIG welder, yeah.
To hold it in place.
Yeah.
Cool. Clean it off. And then you'll finish it off.
Yeah.
Okay. Check in for y'all here.
Yeah, we just grounded off the other tech welds.
Okay.
So we're gonna finish up that bit. And we'll be more or less done with the flex section of it.
Nice.
Gotta weld a couple bungs.
Now really quick, Adam, for the non-car people out there, I figured this would be a good question. I know when I was younger, I had questions about why downpipes had flex sections in them.
It grows, it moves, the engine rocks about. Since we're taking two manifolds and joining them into a single one, if there was no flex in it, it would...
Yeah.
Anything that gets hotter, it simply moves a little bit, and we're talking, you know, 20, 30,000s could be, it could be eighth of an inch. But as it moves around, it gives that ability to walk away from it instead of putting a lot of stress on the weld and on the bends itself. So with that in mind, is last a lifetime, like that's why all the cars have flex sections.
Exactly. And, so that is that is the norm, people.
Swivel joint of some sort. You know, there's no exhaust that's just strapped physically hard with no flex in it, because just like you said. DSM days and some evil days, there's some exhausts out there that don't have anything. You physically bolt it up flange to flange.
Yeah.
And you start losing bolts at the exhaust manifold.
Yeah. And for the record, I've had one of those back in the day that Adam's talking about on my Evo 8, and that thing knocked and hit the cross member and everything else every time, like, the motor moved and rocked. And
Busher exhaust. I don't want to.
Yeah, it was annoying. Here, so flex sections are a good thing, and once again, like Adam said, this is going to be literally hundreds and hundreds of degrees. So.
Yeah, this eventually is going to, that's what I was going with, the heat of the sun welding here.
Yep.
This is going to turn brownish,
coppery, kind of.
Yeah. I mean, it's going to look like ass in 4,000 miles.
Yeah.
And it will, because it's you got 1,500 degree exhaust coming out of it. And so, I mean, it has to constantly change.
Yeah, and if you guys want to get an idea of what, you know, what it may look like, once again, in terms of discoloration and stuff, this will be a good.
Yeah, it won't get. No, we're showing that, but it won't get.
We'll get
this section, it will not get hot. It's the first 6 to 8 feet.
Okay.
They're just going to be brutal. Anything, once it passes the turbo, it'll drop some 700, 800 RPMs.
No kidding.
And then the further it goes, it's still going to burn stuff if it touches, but it's not going to turn colors anymore.
So this back section, the cap back as we would say, is not going to see the temperatures.
Okay. As it travels, yeah.
Cool. All right. Well, much more to come. At this point, Adam is on the home stretch with it, and he's going to look at welding the bungs on for things like the wide band.
Yep, we got them marked in for actually rural two sensors that are going to go in, so where those black dots are.
Cool. So those are the two.
Sensors. So we're going to drill those guys in, weld them in, and bolt it back up, and we'll do the front section of it.
Cool. Sounds good. Accomplished. Wow, that's beautiful. We got the two bungs on there for the O2 sensors once again. Obviously going to be hot here, but common theme here, and the consistent welds by Adam. Alright, so at this point, like we said a couple minutes ago, Adam's got the bungs on. We're going to let it cool off really quick here, and then he's going to, bolt it back up to the vehicle and then start fitting the other section then, right?
Yeah, start pounding away at metal again and, again, massaging. We need to come up with this with a bend, so.
It's the same idea as the other one previously that we did over here. Not rocket science, so check back in with you all in a bit. All right, so we are back, and Adam's got this bad boy bolted up, obviously, at this point. So now the process of fitting and putting together the front section begins. Now, that's going to be a pretty hard bend, I would say, Adam, to... how are you going to route that from there up there? What's that going to look like?
It's actually going to go out It's gonna be a 90 degree bend.
Okay.
So it's gonna be massaged. I like that word, massage.
Yeah, me too. Oh wow.
You're gonna have to pound it flat. I mean, that's all we gotta do.
Okay.
To recreate this shape.
Okay.
In the 90 degree bend.
Yeah.
And on a slight angle up. So we can fit a downpipe. The downpipe still has to come down through here.
Mm-hmm.
There has to be a waste gate that's got to be routed. There's all kinds of stuff.
I was going to say, this has to be the most complicated part.
Yeah, this is where it's getting kind of interesting.
Because then you have your intercooler piping up there too.
Yeah,
to deal
yeah.
with, if I remember right, when the turbo was up there.
Yep.
So this should get interesting.
Bits.
Yeah.
Just keep fighting us now. Good stuff now.
All right, what's up, guys? Once again, happy Friday from Adam and Alan. We're going to wrap it up for the day. Obviously, we accomplished a lot with the fabrication of the exhaust section in the back here. But in terms of what you guys can expect in terms of the next video, I will be back here because I'm lucky enough to have a three-day weekend and the day off on Monday. Today's Friday once again, so I will be back here on Monday to see Adam probably complete, obviously, the front section of the exhaust pipe and to go to the turbo and whatnot. So
and by then we should have the exhaust housing back.
Yeah,
and
from the machine
continue
shop
on with the downpipe and the rest of the exhaust.
Cool. And as you guys can see, this really is the home stretch here. I mean, we have the powder coating done to the intercooler, like we talked about. The intercooler piping's done at this point. Adam's got literally half the exhaust stuff done in terms of those bits. So at this point, I know Adam's thinking, hopefully, if everything goes right in a perfect world,
following Saturday dyno.
Yeah, we should be on the dyno. So literally in the next 10 to 14 days,
let the haters come out then.
Yeah, you guys should be able to see a video. We can see how much power this thing's making,
yeah.
How he tunes it with HP tuners.
We're gonna go through a stock exhaust. Alan talked about doing a cat-back on it,
mm-hmm.
but we'll go to a stock exhaust, see what it does then, and
yeah.
If so, we'll swap the exhaust and put it back on the dyno again and see what the actual exhaust will make as far as power.
See,
I like
that
idea. So.
Yeah, pick up any gains with the cat back, and then also we can get a good idea, you know, of the before and after sound, because I know a lot of people are going to be concerned about how loud is this
yes.
car,
yeah.
You know, with the police and noise restrictions and whatnot. So much more to come, and in my opinion, the most exciting part of the build, which is this thing fired up, running, and making a bunch of power on that badass Mustang dyno over there. So. If you guys haven't, please subscribe if you wouldn't mind. Smash that like button, and like we said, much more to come.
Cheers.
Thank you.